Went from condos to pop's house. On calls now, bus routes. And the one person who had the key to my heart took it and checked out. You know, so, you know, going back to you, Milk, you know, like I said, the first time you came here, you know, I thought this would be great to do this again because people was feeling it, you know, and that's what I always go off of when I do interviews. I want to see how the people receive it. If people are receiving it, they talking about it, they commenting, the numbers are, you know, going up and decent. I'm like, okay, well, let's give them another one. You know, I go off of how the people feel, and people were really feeling the interview, man. One thing that I saw was that people were respecting your past affiliations. Like when you talk about, you know, in the past, like getting put on Hoover and all the things you've been through, I saw people respecting it. Even though you have some people in the media, you know, Brick Baby and others that said negative things, the people, they in the comments, they not feeling like that. They like, nah, we respect what Milk got going on and everything, and we respect Milk's history and him, you know, talking about it. You know, what you got to say about that, like seeing how the people is receiving your past when it come down to your gang affiliations and everything?
Well, I mean, because it just boiled down to, like, they know. Well, if they know that, if they know what it is, then they know that I'm not fake. And I'm not on here faking it. So, I mean, like, what else would they say? I mean, you know, like, you can't say nothing else. You can't say, oh, I came from Riverside, or I came from, well, not Riverside, but, like, Rancho Cucamonga or some shit like that. So, I mean, and then I'm from L.A. Like, a lot of these people know who I am.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of these people know, bro, but.
Yeah,
man, I don't really trip off the comments and shit. Like, I really stopped even worrying about that, like, 2 months into YouTube. But I be reading that shit, though. I like comments. I still comment back, interact with them. So.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, yeah, you definitely can't just focus on it and pay attention to it, you know. I mention it because, you know, people in the comments be tearing. They be tearing shit up. You know what I'm saying? They don't be playing no games, but I noticed when it came down to you, people was like, oh, nah, Milk is real. I respect what Milk is saying. But I'm not saying no names, but we had individuals that came on. They wasn't respecting dudes and what they were saying when it came down to, you know, they passed, you know, affiliations and all of that. So that's why when I saw the way they was receiving you, I'm like, oh, okay, this is what's up, you know?
Yeah, I love it, though. I mean, I love it, bro.
Yeah, real talk, real
talk.
That's
why I stop whenever I see somebody. Whenever, yeah. I'm going to stop and talk to him or whatever.
Yeah. Nah, that's what's up. That's what's up, man. That's all respect, you know. You know, we'll touch on it a little bit. Kind of talking about, what people say on social media. Because, you know, you get the BS, the bull crap. People, you know, trying to knock you, say negative things and everything like that. I don't know if you've seen it, but kind of speaking on, you know, Brick Baby and the things that he said, you know, in the past. After we did the interview, he did like a live stream talking about his ops. And I was kind of surprised that he threw me up in it. I don't know where that came from. I never had no issue with this dude or ever knew this dude or anything like that. You know, but he had you up in there too. I don't know if you saw that live stream that he did.
No, I don't think I've seen this one.
Okay, I saw it because people in the DM show was sending me clips.
No, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that's how I saw it and everything, you know. But that was kind of weird though, you know, just to see the different names, you know, man, all these kind of crazy things, man. But what's your thoughts on it? Last time you was here, you didn't say it was anything in the past with this guy that you had going on, you know? So where do you think a lot of this come from, this tension between you and him?
From me exposing that he used to claim 30s.
Gotcha.
I mean, because he slipped up and said it because he'd be on that liquor heroin. So on an interview, he said it, but nobody paid attention to it. So once I really put the fuel on the fire, that really upset him. And then it's like he can't go get nothing on me. Like he can't go get no paperwork, or he can't go say that I ran out in the county or I did something, bro. So I don't know. But, you know, he a weirdo. Like I can't know nothing about him from the past because I ain't even know who he was. I mean, I seen an interview. Like I remember I did on Say Cheese like a while ago that said his name. That was before Nipsey passed. But
okay.
Nobody, I didn't know who he was. I never even seen Say Cheese on YouTube. I never even was on YouTube. So if you wasn't on YouTube, you wouldn't even know who the guy was. But I think he just really hate me because he can't win. It's nothing he going to be able to say that's going to affect me.
Yeah.
But I'm affecting him because I'm pretty sure he had a lot of people that didn't know that he used to be from 30s or he used to claim 30s before he got forced to bang 60s.
Got you. Okay, got you. You know what I'm saying? You know, but you know, when it come down to that, you could kind of like understand it a little bit. You know, the weird thing with me, you know, because, you know, I interview, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, I sit down, ask questions and everything like that. It was kind of weird how to do, you know, he threw me up in it, and he was mentioning something in regards to, like, I asked him for an interview and he denied it because of the bullshit and everything that I'd be on. And that was kind of weird, you know, because I reached out to Brick Baby before even ever bringing on Cowboy. It was more in the beginning when I reached out to him. And like I said, if he speak on it again, I expose what was really said, but that ain't what happened. In fact, it was totally different, and I don't really think he wanted to come out. You know what I'm saying? So it was weird how he said that he denied an interview. That never happened. And that, like I said, if you continue to lie on me, I'm gonna show people the actual, you know, message on what was said. You don't want that to come out. It's gonna have something to say about you as a person. So, you know, I just don't like to get lied on.
The only reason
I don't know why I'm op. You know, that's kind of weird.
I just posted a video on my Instagram with him wasting some of that liquid heroin, and then he like had the nerves to get a card to like scrape it up and put it in the cup, bro. But Brick Baby ain't shit. Like, he's nothing. If he wasn't getting used that for like protection, he wouldn't even have a job at that podcast, bro. Yeah, you're a failed rapper. He's mad. He upset. He don't got his own platform. He got to work for that man. And only work for that man because he's like a security play, to be realistic, bro. So that's why he mad, bro. But
wow. Well,
you better worry about staying up while you off that shit all day. Not falling asleep driving, you know.
Falling asleep. Oh, man. Which, oh, man, yeah, man. I mean, at the end of the day, man, I mean, like I said, the only reason why I brought it up, we're talking about it right now because, bro, you did a whole live stream talking about your ops. You know, that was weird to me. You know what I'm saying? Super weird, you know. But it is what it is, man. You know, over there on No Jumper, you know, they get people the free rope to say and talk about whatever. So it is what it is, man.